Anyway, today's show is going to be a real good show. Today we're going to talk about simp peer pressure. Getting peer pressure from your simp friends. And just simps in general. We're going to get into that a little bit later, but I want to talk about some other stuff that's going on in the world. It's going to be a goddamn good show today, y'all. Damn good show today. For those who don't know, the rapper T.I. and the rapper Remy Ma have had some startling revelations in their court cases. The rapper T.I. has done a plea deal, and he's going to get 1 year in prison. And I think like a lot of hours of community service. I'm not sure exactly how much. But I'm glad for the brother. I'm glad for him. But that plea deal seems very, very suspicious. And I don't want to accuse nobody of anything. I'm not accusing anybody of nothing. I don't like to put unjustified labels on anybody. But goddamn, how the hell did this dude get 1 year with those fed charges he had hanging over his head? This dude had weapons, silencers, illegal weapons, plus he was a felon. Either T.I. has the best lawyers in Atlanta, or T.I. gave up some goddamn names. And again, I don't want to accuse anybody of no snitch shit. But that's a damn good deal. You get 1 year for all that shit they had on you. I want to believe that his lawyers are off the hook. I really, really do. I want to give him the benefit of the doubt. But damn, I'm just saying. Anybody who know T.I., you just watch what you say around this motherfucker if you got any dirt under your fingernails. That's all I'm saying. 1 year. Again, I hope this brother's lawyers were off the hook. I know how the law is down there in Georgia. They punish a nigga. They throw the book at a nigga down in Georgia. So good for him, man. I'm glad. I wish anybody to go to jail for no long ass time. So I'm glad for the brother. I hope that his lawyers were just really off the hook like that. But I digress. Now, the rapper Remy Ma was found guilty on 4 charges in the assault case. She shot one of her homegirls in the stomach because she said her homegirl stole some money out of her purse, and she stole $3,000 from her, something of that nature. And Remy, she should have plead out on that deal. She should have did some kind of plea deal. I don't know what made her think she was not going to get convicted. That was some very dumb shit. It was some dumb shit that T.I. did, too. But with Remy Ma, the thing she did, she didn't show any remorse. Some of my New York cats were telling me she was on the radio like a few days ago, just popping off about how much money she got and just really just talking some arrogant, dumb shit. And when you have a court case pending, you got to be on your P's and Q's. You got to really, really, really be straight-laced with everything you do. Like, T.I., he did the right thing. T.I. was very smart in the aftermath. It was very dumb what he tried to do by weapons. He should have had somebody else do it for him if you're going to go that route. But what T.I. did, he put on his Easter suit, asked the judge could he go to church for Easter, took a lot of PR photos with him and his family. He played it up real nicely. And see, prosecutors don't like that because when you have a positive public image, it will be harder to get a jury to convict you. So he was kind of smart in that regard. Remy Ma, on the other hand, I don't know what made her think they weren't going to throw her ass up in the clink. Especially running your mouth, beefing with motherfuckers and all that. Even Fat Joe said a few weeks ago, he was like, look, Remy Ma needs to concentrate on her court case and take it more seriously. I remember him saying that in an interview a few weeks ago. And shit, Fat Joe was right. And I don't want to see Remy Ma get locked down for a long-ass time, but folks, black folks, we can't keep doing dumb shit and not expect traumatic results. I don't know what motherfuckers think the result is going to be. People, a lot of niggas be thinking that they're invincible. I don't know where motherfuckers get this mentality from that you can't be touched. I guess people do shit so long, do little small scandalous things so long, they get used to it, then they start doing some real big scandalous shit and get caught up in the mix and then act surprised that they get caught up. Just like those shows on A&E, you always have these cats who been stealing all their lives. They've been robbing motherfuckers and stealing from motherfuckers all their lives. And there's a saying, and I know you've heard this saying, if you will steal, you will kill. If a person will steal, a person will kill. You heard that saying before. And if you look at most murders were basically robberies that went bad. With that football player down in Florida, that was supposed to be a robbery with him, and they end up killing the guy. So a lot of guys, the gateway crime is stealing. A lot of little niggas get so comfortable with stealing, and you never get punished severely. You get away with it so long, you're like, well, shit, I can get away with other shit. I can steal this, I can steal that, I can steal a car, I can steal a durin, I can rob a bank, and I can kill somebody and get away with it. And then when you start doing the murder thing, that brings in a whole different dynamic. But I digress, I'm going on a rant here, but I'm just saying, black folks, cut the dumb shit out. Niggas are doing crime so stupid now, and it's starting at a young age. I saw some shit on the internet about a week ago. It was some kids, I can't think of what city they were in, but they were like 12 years old, 12-year-old boy and a 14-year-old boy. These little niggas tried to rob a police station, not making this shit up. They went into a police station, act like they had a gun. I don't know if they had one or not, but they tried to rob a police station. I don't know if they were in the wrong, they thought they were in another building, but we have that type of dumb shit going on out there. Raise your kids, folks. I'm going to do another show on that later on down the line about all the dumb shit we have with the kids going on because we got dumbass parents, but we're going to get on that later on in another show. We'll talk about that some other time. Speaking of dumb shit, I saw something on the net somebody sent me. Y'all know the what is she? The urban model? What is Buffy the Body? What is her title? Urban model, video vixen, whatever the big ass model, whatever. Whatever, I don't know what her title is. But she's allegedly dating the rapper out of Atlanta, Gucci Mane. And they have like an internet reality show that they're trying to put together. And I'm going to play a clip of it. And I can't understand a goddamn thing neither one of them are saying. Let me play a clip of this right now. I really don't understand anything that they're saying. And hold on, this is it. This is Buffy the Body and Gucci Mane. Here it is.
Tell him the truth right now, Gucci.
Right, you gonna have to call Throwback and
had
them shoes at the bottom
shoes. Gucci, tell him the truth.
Right, get your stuff and don't call me back.
I did not say.
Tell the truth, Gucci.
Yep, then
he said that when I told him.
Gucci,
to,
please tell the truth. Okay, go on and tell the truth.
Bro, I she didn't put me out, but she was like.
Thank you.
But she knew what she said, though. Oh, and by the way, don't call me no more.
No, I didn't say it. Like, when I said
you. I'm like, damn, you know what I mean? You just gonna crush me like that?
No, I didn't say it like that. After I seen him getting his stuff like he about to go, I'm like, well, shit, don't even call me no more, because he wasn't even trying to say, okay, well.
I can't understand one goddamn word so far.
Let me do this, and then I will do what you want to do.
Oh, I told him, I didn't tell him, but I had to tell my best friend, yeah, you be me a tree, man.
I don't.
I might be out of the loop. Maybe I don't have an ear to the streets like I'm supposed to, but I really don't understand nothing these motherfuckers are saying at all. Here it is. Listen.
Be mistreating you, that's a lie. Oh my God, that's a lie.
Well, you
he always want to do what he want to do, but then when I want to do something, all I wanted to do was go to the spa and get massages. He talking about them people might hurt me. I don't want them people doing this and all that.
What the fuck did she say? I really don't understand none of that shit. Hold on. And she said massages? Did she say she going to get massages? Hold on. Listen to this shit.
Bro, she trying to get him to get a massage. You know
what's wrong with a massage? Going to the spa with your girl to get a massage.
Bro, you need to talk to her because she don't know.
Get a massage? This motherfucker said, what's wrong with a massage?
I told him that a man was going to be massaging me. He told me no. He want a woman massage. I want no damn woman massaging me.
Someone with a nigga touching out on her. She butt naked, nigga just grab her. Who want to see that?
Wow. Okay. Again. Sorry about it. Again. Hold on.
All I wanted to do was go to the spa and get massages.
Massages? What the hell is a massage?
What's wrong with a massage? Going to the spa with your girl to get a massage.
And what's funny, that's a great couple, though. That's a wonderful couple. If both of you motherfuckers talk like that, you're perfect for each other. There's somebody for everybody. Men and women, you have to understand that. You're never too undereducated. You're never too overly educated. There's somebody for everybody. If you're a very intelligent guy, there are intelligent women out there. If you can't talk, if you're a dude and your speech patterns are fucked up, this is for you.
All I wanted to do was go to the spa and get massages. He's talking about them people might hurt me. I don't want them people doing this and all that.
What the fuck is, what language is that? That's like, that's like some Star Wars language. I don't know what the fuck they're talking about. But anyway, I digress. I just had to play that for you guys, man. Had to play that for you real quick. But like I said, let me put on some of my Mac music here. Today's show, we're going to talk about simp peer pressure. A lot of simping going on. There was a list going around the internet saying it was GQ's top 25 simps in the entertainment industry. They were talking about celebrity couples and all this shit, and they were talking about some of them are simps. And what's funny, people just got started talking about simps because of my show. The word simp has been around for a long time, but when I started doing my show, that's when the word went back into rotation. When, I'm not trying to pat myself on the back, but I say that because there are a lot of simps who are critical of the show, but a lot of these motherfuckers will take shit from my show and run with it. That's why I put it out. I'm not trying to pat myself on the back. But they were talking about celebrity couples. And speaking of celebrity couples, is Chris Brown really banging Rihanna? I hope he is. I've been seeing a lot of pictures of them, and a lot of times record companies will put out fake stories, you know, that this artist is banging this artist just to kind of keep some controversy up. I hope he's hitting that for real. I hope he knocks some inches off her forehead. I hope he's hitting that. I like Chris Brown. And speaking of Chris Brown, didn't Chris get in a fight at a goddamn club in Germany somewhere? I saw something on the internet where Chris was about to knuckle up with somebody, and I'm like, wait a minute. Come on, Chris. Don't try to have no gangster image. Chris, you're doing good, homie. You can't have no gangster image, Chris. Especially after you done some shit like this.
Elmo, come take a walk with me. It's a beautiful day, and I think we should go out into the neighborhood.
Yeah. You can't be no gangster, Chris. You did a song with Elmo. Whenever Chris want to get into a fight, y'all play this. That'll calm that nigga right down.
Let's take it easy as we go. Elmo, these are the signs.
So Chris, don't try to fight nobody. You done dance with Elmo, nigga. You don't fight nobody. Just keep it R&B, nigga. Anyway, but I digress. But anyway, like I was saying, they have this top 25 list of simps, men who are considered simps. And they were talking about Doug Christie, which I agree. I did a show about Doug Christie a couple of years ago. Again, that's why I know people have been peeping out the show. A lot of magazine articles and a lot of other radio stations, they'll rehash stuff that I've talked about on my show on theirs. I hate to have to point that out, but a lot of their shit they get from me. And they were also talking about Eminem. They put him in the category. They put Mark Anthony in one of the categories. And they put the, I almost said R&B, but Seal doesn't sing R&B. The singer, the pop singer, Seal. And they categorized him as a simp because he was fucking with Heidi Klum when she was pregnant with another dude's baby. And I really wouldn't call Seal a simp because Seal looks a mess. And Heidi Klum is a come-up. So there has to be a little notch in the game for him to get that kind of come-up. Because Seal is a hot mess. And that's the perfect name for that nigga because he looks like a seal. A black-ass seal swimming away from sharks. So he came up with Heidi Klum. I'm not fucking mad at him. That's an ugly motherfucker. Seal is so ugly, that nigga can rob a liquor store with his reflection. You see that nigga reflection, you're just like, hey, take the money, nigga. Just take it. So I'm not mad at Seal. I wouldn't categorize him as a simp. He's just getting in where he fits in, which is nothing wrong with that, especially when you look like somebody beat you in the face with a bag of hot nickels. But there are a lot of simps out there, fellas. There's a lot of simps in the game, fellas. And the simps are starting to take over. The simps have taken over the building. And fellas, all my players, all my guys with game, all my Macs, you got to stand strong with your game. Don't let the simps influence you. Whenever you try to do some fly shit, there's always going to be some simp-ass nigga in your ear with his simp, low self-esteem bullshit. You have to play past that. Because simps are haters, and they hate their situations. They hate the fact that a nigga might have a little more game than them. They hate the fact that they got to trick off money and brown nose and cupcake to be with females. And I touched on this on the last show. So simps will always try to use their peer pressure to get you on the same level they're in. So you never let that influence you. Don't be afraid of criticism from simps. Don't be afraid of criticism from anybody. And I say that to men and women. Because women, you have some simp-ass homegirls or hater-ass cock-blocking homegirls that try to put you into the category they're in, that manless, bitter, Terry McMillan-ass category that they're in. You feel me? So you play past that as well, ladies. Don't let these niggas get in your ear. Whatever you do, you will always find somebody who don't like it. That's the situation with Barack Obama. Barack Obama is doing his thing. And I'm using this example is because it can go all across the board. Like Barack Obama is doing his thing. And you still have a couple of hating niggas coming out saying greasy shit about him. You have the whole Tavis Smiley thing. Trying to throw some dirt on him. And this clown, who I don't even like to acknowledge, this Pastor Manning. This guy that's been on YouTube talking all this retarded shit. And I purposely haven't played any of his clips because I don't want to give him any unwarranted juice at all. I know he's been on Fox News a couple of times, but this guy's a complete idiot trying to talk greasy about Obama, and he talks greasy about a lot of other black folks. But Obama is smart to play past that. You got to play past the simps and the haters and the naysayers and keep on pushing. Like when I do the show, the Mac Lessons radio show. People love the show. Thousands of listeners. Very loyal people. But I hear every now and then there's a handful of simps who try to hate on the game. They'll say some shit. And I look at different message boards. It's always one little simp. Oh, I know all that shit Tariq is saying. Please, why y'all gotta listen to that? You should know that already. I got bitches. You don't have a goddamn thing, niggas. Stop fronting like you got game and you know what's popping. You don't know what's popping. You don't have bitches. You're hiding behind the internet, running your goddamn mouths. Hanging on to every word I say and not giving it up. All my so-called critics, they listen religiously. They're listening right now, hanging on to every word, and won't even give props to it. The game is helping them, or potentially helping them, and they don't want to give props to it. I feel like Will Smith and I Am Legend. There's a bunch of simp-ass zombies out here, and I'm like, I can help you, and they're trying to eat me. That's what it is. And that's what it's like with you players out there. You try to lace some of these niggas with some game. You learn some game. You try to lace your homies. They'll try to eat you alive. They'll try to turn you into a little simp zombie. Don't let these niggas bite you and infect you with that shit. You keep your antidote. And you keep it pushing. I'm telling you, the simps are taking over. Majorly. You don't bow down to that peer pressure. I've always said it. It's lonely at the top, but it's jam-packed on the bottom. Real shit. But yeah, it kills me. I hear niggas try to criticize Flex. They try to criticize what I do. Only a handful. And some women, too. Like on my last show, I talked about Takara on Fight Club. Celebrity Fit Club. I talked about her throwing a temper tantrum. And it was some chick emailed me, Tariq, why you gotta get on the big girls? Why you always clowning thick girls? Every woman can't be a size 2. Ain't nothing wrong with being thick. Some of these dudes can lose weight too. Which, that's a real weak argument that women use, by the way. Whenever the subject of weight comes up, they will, some of these niggas can lose weight too. Women, let me explain something to my ladies out there. It's a little different for men than it is women. Because a man generally isn't judged. His desirability isn't judged on his physical attributes. It's judged on the game he has, the earning potential he has, his mouthpiece, and his career, basically. And his role as a provider. Whereas a woman's value is really judged by beauty first. Your desirability is judged by beauty. So a fat, sloppy ass dude, if he has his paper right, he can always pull dimes. Whereas a woman, that's not going to be the case. It's been like that since the beginning of time. So using the argument, well, there's some overweight men, that's a weak argument. Because he can do that. You can't do that. But I digress. Just let that soak in. Think about that. I know y'all don't like to hear that, but I say that constructively. Not saying that to be mean or facetious. But the problem is the simps are starting to take over because game, having good game, has been pushed to the background because there's so many tricks and simps out here. They have to find a way to make it seem like what they're doing is normal. So they'll try to hate on the motherfucker with some good game to make it seem like the weak shit they're doing is normal. Just like the whole make it rain thing, which I talked about on the last show. They try to make that seem normal. They try to make it seem like cupcaking and kissing the motherfucker's ass is normal. It's not normal, fellas. And I want all my players to not let that influence you. It's not normal. Keep your game tight. Be a man about everything you do. And some of my critics say, well, Tariq, you repeat a lot of the same shit. Well, a lot of you niggas are doing the same shit. That's why I have to repeat a lot of the same shit. Niggas are doing the same thing. I can't take the game to the next level if people are still stuck on level 2. That's why when I do my special shows, the pay-per-view shows, those are for my real advanced players because they'll get it. I'm not going to just throw out whack game. I mean, I'm not going to throw out game for whack niggas who are not going to get it. I'm not going to throw out a bunch of good game and it's just going to go over your head. You dig? But there are my naysayers out there. There's a few people out there who act like I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about. It's always niggas out here fronting like they got it popping better than what they really do. And they don't. I know you don't. I know what your chick looks like. I've said this a million times. Niggas, you can hide behind that internet all day and talk about how much game you have, how many bitches you got. I know what your lady looks like. I know what you niggas are fucking. Your lady looks like a buck-toothed kangaroo. And you need to listen and soak up this fucking game and then give props to it. Be a man and give props. Ain't nothing wrong with giving another motherfucker props. Niggas are so ungrateful. Niggas in America are very ungrateful. African Americans are very ungrateful. Not all. Too many. That's why people get mad at Oprah and all these people. They go to Africa to help out the kids over there. And niggas be like, well, how come they don't help the kids out here? Because niggas are too ungrateful. You try to help niggas out, they bite you in the ass. Niggas are very, very, very ungrateful. Just like going back to the Fat Joe Remy Ma situation. Fat Joe, and I'm not a fan, of, you know, whatever. Their music is all right. I'm not on anybody's side. But I know that Fat Joe helped Remy Ma out, and she turned around and dissed him. Making diss records about the dude, dissing him on the radio. That was some ungrateful shit. There's a lot of situations like that. You help people out and they turn around and talk shit about you like you're nothing. And a lot of niggas soak up your game and then turn around and talk shit like they rolling like that. But niggas are very ungrateful. Get off that ungrateful shit. And I say that to the simps out there. My players, most of my players who listen to the show, they're grateful. They give up props. I've given up props. If I see somebody doing some fly shit, I'm the first one to congratulate them. If I see somebody trying to do something, even if the effort is kind of lackluster, I'll be there to try to help them. That's why when I was talking about Tyler Perry the other day, it was very constructive. A lot of niggas, dudes, are real quick to shit on Tyler Perry. That's a brother trying to do some positive shit. Now, his TV show, That House of Pain, it's not a hot show. I'll admit that. But I try to go see this man's movies because I want him to get that Hollywood clout. I want this brother to win. That's a lot of pressure on this dude. He came from nothing. So you support that dude. Get off that hater shit. Yeah, some of that shit is corny, but support that dude. And my players out there, don't look for support, though. Don't wait on the niggas in the hood or the niggas you grew up with to support you or support any fly shit you're doing. You keep on doing you. Play past the simps. Do not bow down to simp peer pressure because they want you to be a loser just like them. They want you going to the strip joints with your paycheck just like them. They want you to cupcake with females just like them. And that's not what you do, player. Keep that shit 100. Keep that shit Mac-ish. See, the problem is, man, everybody's fronting. We got to get it right back to personal relationships. I want my players out there to focus on having personal contact with women and making a good personal impression. That's where macking starts off first and foremost, man. It starts off with you making a good impression on everybody you encounter. Simps hate on everything. Simps find fault in everything. Men and women, hater women, hater dudes, they'll find fault in everything. So my players out there, you can't appease them. You can't do anything to kind of cater to them. Because when you start trying to cater to them, that's when you're going to fall off. Like in Hollywood. I know a lot of actors, a lot of black actors who date white women. But they'll hire or get their PR firm to hire them to hire a black female to walk up and down the red carpet with them. To kind of please their female audience. I hate that they would have to do some shit like that. You do you. You do what feels mackish in your heart, because whatever you do, somebody's going to find fault in it. If you date a white woman, somebody's going to say, well, how come you don't date a woman of color? If you date a Puerto Rican, you're like, fuck it, let me go date a Puerto Rican. They're going to say, well, damn, she's Puerto Rican, but how come she ain't black? You date a black female, somebody will say, well, she black, but how come she light skinned? How come you get a full black woman? How come you had to get a mixed chick? So you get a full black woman, somebody will still complain. Well, look at her, she wear a weave. Why you have to get a black woman with a weave? You must hate yourself. You want a woman with fake hair. So you get a black woman with an afro. And people still find fault. They're like, oh shit, she's bougie. She seemed like she's in the suburbs. How come you couldn't get a real sister? And then when you show up with this,
all I wanted to do was go to the spa and get massages. He's talking about them people might hurt me. I don't want them people doing this and all that.
So when you show up with some shit like that, people will be like, well, damn, how come you got to get a ghetto broad? How come you got to get a female who ain't up to... They'll find a reason to complain. So fuck them. Fuck them. You do you. You keep it mackish. Don't try to please nobody. Again, work on your interpersonal relationships. Work on your communication skills. Work on bettering yourself. Stay away from simp haters with simp ass peer pressure. Because everybody's fronting now. The reason why cats don't really know how to spit like they're supposed to and all this simp shit has become the norm because of the technology we have. It's stopping interpersonal relationships. We don't know how to communicate like we're supposed to. Like back in the day, I have an old school spirit. I'm up on technology, but I still have an old school spirit. See, back in the days, even before I was a kid, back in the day, you were judged by how tight your mouthpiece was. You were judged by the impression you made with people. Now, when dudes try to talk to females, you got cell phones now. You can sit up on the cell phone with a chick all day. You have text messaging. You can sit up and text message a female all day and night. You can sit up and instant messenger a female all day and night. You can get on MySpace, texting them and emailing them back on MySpace and email. And you can talk to a female for weeks and months at a time without even seeing her in person. So your nonverbal skills are not being honed. Whereas back in the day, if you liked a female, you had to go take a bath, iron your jeans, iron your clothes, put some Murray's grease in your hair, walk over to her house and put your goddamn bed in. So your personal skills, so your game was a little tighter back then. Your game had to be a little tighter. Your body language had to be tight. Everything about you had to be fly. Even with women too. Women had to make a good impression back in the day. Now women shake their ass on YouTube and get a million niggas giving her attention. Everybody's fronting now. Especially black folks. We're fronting like a motherfucker when it comes to relationships and dating and dealing with other people. We're going overboard trying to impress people by bullshitting. You got a fake picture up on MySpace. She got a fake ass picture up on MySpace. She got a picture of just her face. You got a picture of you standing in front of your homeboy's car with a handful of money in your hand. She fronting about what she do. You fronting about what you do. You're like, hey, babe, what you do for a living? I'm a model. What you do? I'm a baller. Neither one of y'all ain't shit. Motherfuckers are front. This is the fronting generation. You know, back in the day, it was like, look, I ain't got no money. You ain't got no money. I like you. You like me. God damn it, let's do this. But right now, everybody's fronting and nobody likes who they are. So everybody's bullshitting, other people, and then eventually they start bullshitting themselves. And this is where the simping comes in. Because these simps don't have any kind of interpersonal skills. When they do see a guy with personal skills who know how to communicate and be charismatic and deal with people like that, they kind of throw salt on them because they don't know it. They don't know how to do that. They got to hide behind the computer and sit up on MySpace and message boards talking shit all goddamn day. But this is the fronting generation. You talk to a female now, her conversation is so bullshit, it's like, oh, God, give me a fucking break. Yeah, I'm a model. Yeah, I'm about to shoot for Playboy. And, you know, dudes, some dude offered me $5,000 to go shopping. And shut the fuck up. And shut your goddamn ass up. And niggas, y'all be fronting too. And see, the females are followers. They see y'all niggas fronting, and they feel like they can front too. Y'all niggas be fronting too. Niggas always putting extras on what they got. Yeah, nigga, I got a gang of bitches. Yeah, I got so many bitches. And please, your lady looks a mess. You look a mess. Niggas always putting extra. Niggas acting, especially niggas who try to be hustlers. These wannabe drug dealers trying to act like they got more dope than they really have. You know what I'm saying? You talk to niggas now like, yay, what's up, man? You know me. I'm just trying to move this weight. Nigga, what weight you trying to move? You sell ecstasy tablets. You ain't got no weight. Niggas kill me. Like, yeah, what's up, Flex? You know me, man. I'm just trying to move this work. You know what I'm saying? Trying to wait on my shipment. What shipment, nigga? You sell Vicodin. Come on now, Hollywood isn't going to get Denzel to play you in a movie, so calm down, nigga, you're not Tony Montana. Stop putting extras on shit, be yourself, work on your interpersonal skills, stop bowing down to peer pressure, stop letting simp bitch-ass niggas influence you, and for you simp bitch-ass niggas, stop running your mouth. Learn how to appreciate when somebody laces you with game. Like Will Smith said in I Am Legend, I'm trying to save you. But I'm not going to put myself in jeopardy or waste my time trying to help you niggas. Because let me explain, motherfuckers. I don't have to do the Mac Lessons radio show for my little handful of cats who kind of throw their little criticisms. I do it for cats who supported me throughout the years. People ask me to do the show. When I haven't done a show in a long time, people are like, please, man, we need a show. I do this for them. So you sit your ass back in the sidelines and soak up the game or shut the fuck up. I don't have to do the show. I chill off. I can be in Tahiti or the Caribbean somewhere, nigga. I do this for my folks to help them out with their shit. So y'all shut the fuck up and soak up this game too. Lay up there with that ugly bitch of yours and let her soak up some game too. Anyway, I digress. That's been today's episode of the Mac. You get 1 year for all that shit they had on you. I want to believe that his lawyers are off the hook. I really, really do. I want to give him the benefit of the doubt, but damn. I'm just saying. Anybody who know T.I., you just watch what you say around this motherfucker if you got any dirt under your fingernails. That's all I'm saying. 1 year. Again, I hope this brother's lawyers were off the hook. I know how the law is down there in Georgia. They punish a nigga. They throw the book at a nigga down in Georgia. So good for him, man. I'm glad. I wish anybody to go to jail for no long ass time. So I'm glad for the brother. I hope that his lawyers were just really off the hook like that. But I digress. Now, the rapper Remy Ma was found guilty on 4 charges in the Asmart in the aftermath. It was very dumb what he tried to do by weapons. He should have had somebody else do it for him if you're going to go that route. But what T.I. did, he put on his Easter suit, asked the judge could he go to church for Easter, took a lot of PR photos with him and his family. He played it up real nicely. And see, prosecutors don't like that because when you have a positive public image, it will be harder to get a jury to convict you. So he was kind of smart in that regard. Remy Ma, on the other hand, I don't know what made them think, what made her think they weren't going to throw her ass up in the clink. Especially running your mouth, beefing with motherfuckers and all that. And that's the, even Fat Joe said a few weeks ago, he was like, look, Remy Ma needs to concentrate on her court case and take it more seriously. I remember him saying that in an interview a few weeks ago. And shit, Fat Joe was right. And I don't want to see... Anyway, today's show is going to be a real good show. Today we're going to talk about simp peer pressure. Getting peer pressure from your simp friends. And just simps in general. We're going to get into that a little bit later, but I want to talk about some other stuff that's going on in the world. It's going to be a goddamn good show today, y'all. Damn good show today. For those who don't know, the rapper T.I. and the rapper Remy Ma have had some startling revelations in their court cases. The rapper T.I. has done a plea deal and he's going to get 1 year in prison. And I think like a lot of hours of community service, I'm not sure exactly how much. But I'm glad for the brother. I'm glad for him. But that plea deal seems very, very suspicious. And I don't want to accuse nobody of anything. I'm not accusing anybody of nothing. I don't like to put unjustified labels on anybody. But goddamn, how the hell did this dude get 1 year with those fed charges he had hanging over his head? This dude had weapons, silencers, illegal weapons, plus he was a felon. Either T.I. has the best lawyers in Atlanta, or T.I. gave up some goddamn names. And again, I don't want to accuse anybody of no snitch shit. But that's a damn good deal. Salt case, she shot one of her homegirls in the stomach because she said her homegirl stole some money out of her purse, and she stole $3,000 from her, something of that nature. And Remy, she should have plead out on that deal. She should have did some kind of plea deal. I don't know what made her think she was not going to get convicted. That was some very dumb shit. It was some dumb shit that T.I. did, too. But with Remy Ma, the thing she did, she didn't show any remorse. Some of my New York cats were telling me she was on the radio like a few days ago, just popping off about how much money she got and just really just talking some arrogant dumb shit. And when you have a court case pending, you got to be on your P's and Q's. You got to really, really, really be straight-laced with everything you do. Like, T.I., he did the right thing. T.I. was very